Hey, Andrew. Curiosity killed the cat, and so would being on a neutron star. So today I'm going to take a crack at explaining neutron stars to you. Just like my high school astrophysics teacher did to me in like 2005 or something. God help us. So neutron stars form when a star dies, and the star was in a special mass range where it was heavy enough to go supernova, but not so heavy that a black hole forms after that. So the range, that mass range is about 1.5 to 3 times the size of our sun. After neutron stars form, they are super small for a star, like on the order of 10 or 20 miles across. You could line up a few hundred neutron stars between here and Florida. You might be surprised to learn that neutron stars are made of neutrons, entirely of neutrons. They are so dense and compressed that all of the protons and electrons that originally made up the hydrogen and other heavier elements in the star combine to form neutrons. So in astrophysics, we pretty much talk about hydrogen and heavier elements. Maybe hydrogen, helium, heavier elements, but that's really it. Anyway, so it's a joke. My teacher used it. So protons and electrons combine to form neutrons. Or you can think of it like that, but that's not exactly what's happening. It's a little more complicated than that, but that's another video. So the question is, why doesn't a neutron star collapse further and form a black hole? Like, given the intense gravitational pressure from cramming together 1.5 to 3 times the mass of our sun into a sphere small enough that you could hike across it in a day, what's pushing back up and keeping the neutron star not a black hole? The answer, partially, is the neutron hotel. Partially is one of those physics words that means I'm not really going to explain all this right now because either I don't know or you're too dumb to understand. I'll leave determining which is the case here as an exercise to the reader. So, question is, what's pushing up against gravity? It's called neutron degeneracy pressure. So the Pauli exclusion principle states that two identical fermions, which is a class of particles including neutrons, can't occupy the exact same state. This is the same thing that keeps like in electron orbitals, like you learned about in chemistry. Each electron has like its own spin and orbital, and none of them are exactly the same. So same thing. So the neutrons become so packed tightly together that it's only the fact that two fermions, like neutrons, can't occupy the same space that is keeping them apart. So they're crammed right next to each other. So you can think of the space where the star is as a neutron hotel. You can only fit one neutron in each hotel room. Once there's a neutron in the hotel room, it refuses to share. No room in the inn for Mary Neutron and Joseph Neutron. Physicists are not the most creative people in the world, but they really like pulled it out for this one and call the force that pushes one neutron away from the other, keeping them in their separate hotel rooms, the strong nuclear force. So at this point, question that I'm sure you're asking is, how does a black hole ever form then? If neutron degeneracy pressure keeps the neutrons from condensing further, how does a black hole ever form? How is there ever enough pressure to overcome the strong nuclear force? The answer is with stars that are more massive. Gravity is eventually stronger than the strong nuclear force with enough mass. So stars that are even more massive and go supernova, when they then collapse, the increased gravity from the increased mass is enough to overwhelm the poor neutron hotel innkeeper. The neutrons crowd in, several of them in a room, and the innkeeper freaks out and burns the place down. Because he's homophobic and doesn't like two neutrons sharing a hotel room. Ain't right. So that's neutron stars. They're held up by neutron degeneracy pressure, which is explained by the Pauli exclusion principle, and they only happen in a special range of mass between black holes on this side and smaller stars on this side. Hope that you feel like you learned something. I had fun remembering this, looking up details, explaining it to you. miss you a lot. I'll talk to you soon.